A middle school social studies class.
You're not going to tell me how you voted. You're going to write it down on a piece of paper. So,
taking a presidential preference straw poll.
You guys voted 11 for Trump and 2 for Clinton.
A different school. Also middle school social studies.
It's 17 for Clinton, 3 for Trump, and 2 for Gary Johnson.
We spent part of the day here at the Roosevelt Middle School in West Orange, New Jersey, a state expected to overwhelmingly go for Hillary Clinton. And we spent part of the day here at the Clark's Moore Middle School in Richmond, Kentucky, a state expected to overwhelmingly go for Donald Trump.
So what would the classroom experiences be like? And how different would they be?
Fighting ISIS and protecting our country is more important right now than global warming.
Well, not surprisingly, plenty of praise for Trump in Kentucky.
I voted for Trump because I believe that he speaks his mind clearly and doesn't hesitate to speak for what he believes in.
And in Jersey,
Mackay,
loyalty towards Clinton.
During the debates, Donald Trump wouldn't really offer solutions to a problem. Like, people would ask, oh, what are you doing about cops and African Americans, like how people are getting shot. Donald Trump would be like, oh, that's a very bad issue, and when I become president, I will change that. He's not really saying what exactly will happen.
But in the Garden State and in the Bluegrass State, the social studies teachers had something very much in common, playing devil's advocate with the majority, wanting their students to at least consider both sides. In Kentucky,
I think Trump's idea is good because he wants to basically get rid of all the people who got in here illegally and make them come back legally and actually become an American citizen, not sneak in illegally.
All right, is that going to be doable? How many are there?
Millions.
Okay, how is that going to be doable?
I think he's going to get a lot out, but not all of them.
And in New Jersey.
Should it be harder if I wanted to buy a gun?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah? But what does the Constitution say about it? Does anyone know? Dylan?
We have the right to bear arms.
We have the right to bear arms. So whose side is the Constitution on in many ways? Is it on the side of people who want to make guns harder to get, or people who support the idea that it should be pretty easy to get a gun? It's on their side.
There were spirited disagreements between students. Here in Kentucky, between this Trump supporter.
And if we take away the coal mines, a lot of people from Kentucky will not have jobs. And the more people that have jobs, the more money we get for taxes.
And this Clinton supporter.
She's trying to make not so many gases so the global warming doesn't affect us as much.
But there was another similarity between the students at both schools. Respect for each other. Civility. A good lesson for lots of adults. Gary Tuchman, CNN, West Orange, New Jersey, and Richmond, Kentucky.